I was doing a live video training session the other evening, and when I was done, the host that organized it, we made contact after the session was shut down, and I just cared to mention to them that I actually did that. It was pre-recorded and I was streaming it, and they were quite shocked that it was that way. Well, the first thing about the story is that you, if you're going to do any recording that's going to be pre-recording, you want it to be natural. You got to kind of do it with all the, you know, the pimples in your explanation. You make a couple of sort of pauses and errors as if you're talking naturally, like you're doing it real time. So you don't edit the every single thing out of it. So it was edited, but I left a couple of ums and, you know, a bit of slip ups here with not making it too obvious. So it looked like it was happening in real time. So that's on one side of the thing. But what I want to speak about is how I set it up, just to help those folk who want to actually use a program and stream through an existing video or some sort of setup through into the video conferencing software. So the tools that I'd recommend you use, oh, by the way, what I'm going to show it in is the Jitsi, which is an open source platform. You go to meet.jit.si and you can create your open source video conferencing room. It's all free. It's democratizing web communication through WebRTC and all that sort of stuff. So if you're not into Zooms or nowadays you could use Telegram for the same purpose also, but I'm going to use Jitsi. And the key thing is here, what we're going to feed through with the actual mic and the video. So in the case like this, if I pop video off here, you're going to see that one is this Irion mic, which is a, not Irion mic, but it's the webcam. So it's a piece of software that connects my mobile device through here. And this one is my OBS virtual camera. So OBS comes with this virtual camera. If you switch it on there, it's able to stream whatever you have in OBS, which is going to be the key here. We're going to use OBS. And instead of a video picture of ourselves, we're going to load a video and stream it through. So as far as the video conferencing software goes, the video that they are seeing is not a webcam or anything. It's actually coming from OBS. Then the other thing that we need to manage through here is going to be the audio signal. So this will carry the video signal from OBS, which is the software I'll explain where we can get it from. And then the audio signal will have to be routed, and that is slightly a little bit more challenging. And there's two different ways of doing it. One that is part of OBS. You can do it just inside OBS with maybe one free other sort of installation. And the other one is more sophisticated, that you have lots more flexibility. So if we have time, I'll go through that second one also. But in that case, we will load it up as the mic. So the mic coming in here is coming from your OBS, and the video is coming from OBS. So everything is going to take place in OBS. And as far as the other users on the other side are concerned, the video they're seeing is something coming from your video camera here, and the audio they're hearing from your camera, but you're feeding it via OBS. Okay, so most gamers use that setup. So the first thing that I recommend you get is, you can go to this website, vb-audio.com. You can get paid parts of it. So there's lots of software guys who have been checking out this. There's VoiceMeter, Banana, VoiceMeter, Potato, etc. Like strange names, but they virtual cables that connect things. And they're used by a lot of folk who want to have virtual setups that they connect one piece of software with another piece of software internally in the computer. What I did was I got both of these sets. You give a donation to them, VB cable A and B. So that's two cables, and VB cable C and D is another two cables. So all in all, it's four cables that you have access to. But if you don't want to donate or pay for anything, I'm not too sure where it is. If it's this one, I think you could get the one that's just a single cable, which will be totally free to download. And you can get away with that. You don't have to have these two. I just thought it's a good thing to support them. And then I found other uses for it. So pretty much what it is it gives you, if you get all four of these, you're going to have these four plus the free one. So it's five cables. You install it, you'll have to restart your computer because it needs to add it as an independent driver. Like you'd have an external sound card, this now puts in a virtual cable. So this is what we're going to use to connect from our OBS that we're going to install and pass it to the virtual signal coming through to our video conferencing software, which is Jitsi in this case. Okay, so this is the software we use. And then the software we need, OBS, it's totally free. If you, depending on which version you run, I run Windows, and you download this, install it. Now, I'm not going to give a tutorial on OBS itself. You've got to kind of do your own investigation there. I'll assume you have some sort of knowledge of that. Yes, and then the next thing that you need, which is for this more advanced routing of audio from OBS, is a thing called audio monitor. You can just type in OBS audio monitor plugin. It will come over here. You go to it and then you download this plugin and then you can install it into OBS. So it makes it part of OBS integration. And you'll see this, if you look at this here, now we'll see it a little bit later, filters for audio. So you'll have something that you load like a source, whether it's a audio source or something, maybe a pre-recorded piece of video. You can then interject it in, sort of put it in between this, and when it goes out, you can add this audio monitor and you can feed it through a different device. So like this particular thing could go through that device. You could load another one here and send it through a different device. It's actually very cool. But I don't want to confuse you with those stuff for now. This would be the more advanced way of pulling in an extra plugin. I will firstly show you how that free a virtual cable can be used just inside OBS on its own. Okay, so we've got the plugin, we've got OBS, and we've got these virtual cables. Okay, so when we pull this up now, let me just maximize this. Okay, so this is OBS. I've got it on studio mode. I prefer it on studio mode. If you go single mode, you literally, when you load the stuff, they just come on one screen. The nice thing with studio mode is if I have it here, it's going to be able to give me an option to put stuff in here. And when I'm ready, I can transition it across. What's on the right side is actually what goes out to the audience that are watching. Okay, so let's just go through a few significant things here just to make sense of it. So here, start virtual camera. Because I've got nothing here, maybe I should just pull out the YouTube thing, not YouTube. Okay, let me just show you here. This is your Jitsi Meet. So this is the default picture that's coming on here. Now, I haven't entered this meeting yet, but the nice thing about Jitsi, it shows you your video before you even enter the meeting. So if I go to OBS and I'm going to, if I switch the virtual camera on, it's now going to show me a black screen. So let me click here. I go, okay. It says there's nothing here, so you know, be aware of that. I'm saying, okay, I'm going to just send. So I'll just click transition. So it's just transitioning nothing. So there's nothing here. So if I open up here now, you'll see it's gone all black. If I go back here and if I go and I want to add something to the scene, so I've got to add a source. Just to show you, I'm going to add a simple image. I'm not going to even give it any other label. I'm going to search for this file. If you go to pictures, just find something. Okay, find this lady. So she's over there. If I move it here, if you go back here, you're going to see nothing still. Okay, because this on the right is what's pulling through. So if I transition here now and I open this, you'll see that image comes through. If I go and I hide this, and if I go back, you'll still see the image. But if I transition the blank screen across there now and you go back, you'll see that would have gone. So whatever's here is actually showing through in the virtual camera. And as I mentioned earlier, the virtual camera that I've chosen here is this OBS cam. Now, if you have other cameras like webcams and all that, that's part of your maybe laptop, you'll see them appear here as choices. Okay, so we've got the OBS. So that part of it is sorted out. So if I go now in here and okay, I'm going to take that image out there. I'm going to go put in a piece of media now. Now the media works slightly different. You can make it start automatically. It can loop every time you open it. It can go back to the start. So those things you learn as per OBS. I'm just showing you the routing here. I'm going to go to a media source. So I'm going to look for a video clip. Here you see if I play it and then I stop it and I play it again, it's just going to jump back to the start. If I disable that, then there's a little sort of slide bar. I can control it or loop, etc. I'm going to just leave it at defaults. Let's just go into a video. Okay, this video, I'm going to pull this one in. So I'm pulling this video in and I'm saying, okay, now it's not showing here because it's not playing at the moment. Okay, it will start playing when I move it across into this way here. So if we look now at the Jitsi, nothing's happening there. If I go and I say, let's transition. Now, it would have been nice to see a little thumbnail here of this video. But yep, maybe there's some other way of doing that. But for me now, I know that the eye is on. So it is live here. And if I transition, you'll see it starts to play here. Okay, my proportions are a bit out here. So I'm going to just go here, right click and say transform and fit to screen. Now it's fitting here, but here you see it's still out of proportion because it hasn't transitioned across. Merely because I'm using the studio modes. If I say transition, there you see the sizes will fit. But very interesting, you'll notice here that when I'm playing, the audio is going out here and it says video. It's related to this particular video. Now, I'm going to just pause this over here. When I look at this here as an audio mixer, remember I spoke about the plugin. The plugin is going to give you access on this side to route things out. But this is the standard thing that comes with OBS. This is just telling you that's the audio signal that is coming through, and you can turn the signal down, up, you can mute it. And if you click on here, you can get access to certain things that we need to be aware of. Or you just right click on here and you can go to advanced properties. It will take you to the same place. But before we open that, just to show you under settings, this is going to be key. If you click on settings, the main thing that I do, this is just my choice. I go to audio and I disable these other areas because if I'm going to send it out, stream it out somewhere, I don't want it to be looping back anywhere. So this is just my settings. It might not work for you. If you want to be able to hear your desktop sound, you can click here and say it must go to your speakers, etc. Like I've got a USB audio box there. I've also got my speakers on my Samsung mic or my other speakers. And here you notice those virtual cable stories. We'll cover that now. But I just leave this disabled. So this just means that no audio will be tracked through to a desktop audio device, etc. No mic inputs are going to be brought in into this area. This is the thing that I want to highlight here. At the moment, whatever's going to be playing here, out here, is going to give a monitor out feed here. And or feed. This is what we want to send through to the video conferencing software. Now, at the moment, it's been sent to the audio USB. So if I click here, remember what I said is we have these cables. Now, you'll notice I have cable B. This one here that has no A, B, C, or D on it, that is the free one, okay? So you can choose that one, or C, or D, whichever you choose. But whichever one you choose here, this as the monitoring device, when you go to your video conferencing software, your mic input has to be the same. So if I choose B here, my mic input must be B. Because what it's doing, it's sending a signal over here through this monitoring device. It's monitoring over, let's use cable A to keep things simple. Where is cable A? I've got to measure that's cable D. There's cable A right at the bottom. So I'm going to choose cable A. So what's happening is when I play this video, we don't have a problem with the video. It's going via this virtual camera that's feeding through. This is specifically for the audio. So I'm saying whatever audio is going to come out of the OBS program, I'm going to send it, this monitoring section, I'm going to send it over cable A. And if I want to hear that in another program, in the other program, I've got to put cable A as being the input, like a mic input into that. So then I will hear it on that side and see the signal come through. So I'm saying cable A is my monitoring channel. I apply that and say, okay. So now if I play this, it's going out here and it would go through if I come here. If I now come here to the video things, you see the video is playing. Let me see where the audio is. Under the audio of this particular virtual conferencing tool, we have microphones and the speakers. That's specifically for this section of things. This is not got to do with OBS's controls. But we need to go to the mic input. We need to go to the cable A. Okay? So if we look here, we are seeing that there's audio coming through here because this is the mic I'm using to do this recording. But cable A is the one that we need to utilize. But very interesting, you're seeing something here. This CRISP is artificial intelligence that clears up messages if I use that as my driver. Don't worry about that. CRISP is there also. But you see my mic here, which is on my laptop, is picking this up. Okay, so that's why you're seeing these signals. But the one that I'm sending this video out with is supposed to come over cable A, but you see cable A is dead here. Okay, let me tell you why that is dead, because if you come back here, remember I said this is the settings, or if you right click, so I'm going to go with right click for now. You go to advanced settings, you are going to see, okay, that has stopped. Let me just restart this. Okay, if you look here on this video channel that we're talking about, this is an important setting that you have to have here, because whatever's coming through here has to be pushed through where it's going to go out. And once it goes out here, then it knows that the settings are going to take it further out. At the moment, I'm saying this particular video channel, the monitoring is off. So nothing's going out of the monitoring channel. I can say monitor must be on, but I don't want to listen to it locally on the computer. Okay, or I could say monitoring must be on and my output on my local computer must be on so I could hear it. So in this case, I just want what I'm playing there to monitor only must be. I must mute whatever's playing on this local device. This takes a bit of getting used to if you're not familiar with it, and experiment with it. But in our case, I want the monitor to be on. So what's playing here must go via monitor out. You will see what happens on the other side now. Monitor out. And it's still playing there, but let's look at what happens here. Can you see under cable A? Can you see now there it's coming through? It's whatever this video is happening is actually now playing. So if I select cable A as my oh no, that's output, eh? Let's leave that maybe at, let's see where, oh, these are speakers, those are mic. No, I'm right. That's for my microphones, will be under cable A. So you can see my cable A is now giving sound because the video is now playing through. So if I start this up now, if I say join this meeting, probably this thing has come to an end. I should put it just on to loop. Let me just click here and say loop so we don't have to restart it every time. So what you're going to have here now is you're going to see up here, do you see those three dots? Maybe I'm going to make it easier for you to see it on the left here. If you look on the side here, you're going to see the dots go. And those dots are indication that there's audio coming through via. So the video is feeding via my virtual thing out of OBS. And my input mic here is coming via my cable A. And my cable A is the same thing I'm using to take out of OBS and monitor it into this program. This is where it's coming here. If I go and change my monitoring output now to cable B, then you'll see this one will highlight. So literally what I'm doing, I am taking out of OBS, let's follow this path. I'm playing the video, it's going and showing me here's the video. If I go to the settings, I must make sure that I'm sending this actual signal out to the monitor section, which is in the settings here. Okay, so I'm saying yes, send it to the monitor, mute the normal output. I just want to send it to that monitor because I know that monitor is going to take it over to the Jitsi platform. If I go to settings, under audio, there you can see the monitor device that it's sending. It's going boom out to the A cable. And when I get to the Jitsi platform, via the A cable, it's coming in as audio here. So in that case, now I can play something inside of here. Even if I bring another piece of audio, if I play it here, it's going to stream across. Go out here through there. Okay, so I'm going to try and do the next lot just quickly. Hopefully I've got you focused on what I'm doing here. But now let me just explain where those other filters come through. Now in this case, I could even come here. Let me show you this. I could use this program and I can say I want to put the monitor off. Okay, So I can say off, which means now if I go here, whatever I set here on monitor, this audio cable, there's nothing coming to it now because I've actually switched off the monitor here. Even though you're seeing this here, nothing is going out via the monitor channel. So even if I have it on A and I have the video conferencing on A, nothing will be coming through on that side. Okay, you'll see it standing totally dead over there. So what is the purpose of that other plugin? With that plugin, I can actually bypass this monitor instruction and bypass the settings. I'm literally taking it out of here, out of the source, and pushing it via a virtual cable straight out to the other thing. Let me show you here. Let's just check again. There you see cable A is standing quite static. My Samson is making movement because I'm talking on it. But cable A is non-movement, even if the video is playing. Look what I do here is if I right click on here, or I can click filters. If I right click and I go to filters, okay, look what is happening here. I'm on that particular media. So whatever I'm putting in here is going to apply just to that media. If I go to the plus now, you're going to see there it says audio monitor. Okay, so this audio monitor is the plugin. So this is actually bypassing this mute and sending out to my monitor, and it's actually bypassing what I put in the settings. This controls everything from this point. So if I go audio monitor, I'm going to say, let's say cable, yeah, my spelling, cable A, say okay. Okay, so now at the moment I can hear this sound. I don't know if you can hear it. Let's just let it start up. Okay, I can hear it on my earphones because it's playing through the default. Now, it's playing through the default even though this setup, like I said, is switched off. It is, let me take you there again. I know I'm overplaying this now, but you see monitors off and outputs off. There's nothing on here, but I can hear it through my earphones because this plugin over here is sending it to cable A, but I've just labeled it as cable A. It's not yet cable A because the device is actually default, which is my earphones now. If I flip this over now, if I click here, you'll see it says cable B, D, and cable A there. So if I do this, it's switching off my earphones because it's not sending it to my earphones. It's now sending to cable A. Now, even if I don't close this, now I'm going to go here, you're going to see the signal coming through here. See cable A? Can you see that? It's reading through cable A. Isn't that cool? So what this filter plugin does, it basically bypasses the system that OBS uses for its system routing and its monitor routing. So it's not sending it via here and it's not using your settings. It's primarily just using this. Now, the question might be asked, well, if this happens here, can I put another one in here? And the answer is yes. Like this is going straight through to the virtual cable. I can put in another part of the plugin here. I can add another one and make it come to my earphones. So it could be sending here and to my earphones. And I can add another one sending here, my earphones and somewhere else. You see how powerful that gets? So if I go here and I say another audio meter, and I'm going to say earphones, check there now. It's coming through to my earphones. I've got it on default, but let me just see headphones. So it's playing through my headphones, and because I've got both of these filters on this very same video channel, it's playing through my headphones and through the A cable. And I can put multiple ones on here. So I can actually send through monitoring of audio through to various devices even. This is extremely powerful. So let me just show you here. If I open here, you can see it's still coming through A. And I can hear it through on my earphones here, mainly because I've used the filter right on this channel. So again, let me just stop this one here. I don't want to have that play. Let me remove it. There it goes silent on my earphones. So in essence, you can either go and use this monitor setup and right click and go set monitor and output and that, or you could just disable those like that. In your settings, it doesn't matter where that's going to, because this is all disabled. And everything you add here, the beauty of adding it under sources with that plugin is that if you come in and you add, let's say you're going to add another media source, and this media source is going to be an audio file. Let's look for an audio file quickly. Venishalom. So if the audio file is over here, you could actually go to the audio file and you can, onto that, you add a filter and you say the audio file must play to my ears. So that's to my earphones. And then you can pull that through to your earphones. Okay, so the audio file of Venishalom is going to play to your earphones, but it's not going to go out of your system or to cables or anything, virtual cables. Well, while this one is going out, because that's how it's routed. But you're not hearing, I'm not hearing anything here because it's still the media files on the side. If I select the media file now and I say transition, there you're hearing it. Okay, so this is playing now through, you can see as the media source. If I look at the media source here now that I've loaded, just click here, even advance, you can see they're both monitors off, so nothing is going out by where I have on the settings. Nothing's going out really. It's going primarily through this plugin through the virtual cables. Now while I'm at it, I'm going to just go in here and let me go change this filter. I'm going to go, instead of my ears, I'm going to say let's change this to virtual cable A. And if you look at it, virtual cable A will be rocking with Venishalom, the audio that comes from the video, and everything playing through here, because I'm sending them all through the same cable. So okay, this has been kind of a session. Hopefully I haven't confused you too much. It took me a while to kind of get my head around it. So let me just close this off. It took a while for me to get my head around, let me stop this, around the whole factor about, you know, if I'm using this and I'm sending it out via monitor, what function does the filters have of audio monitor here? And after I realized that they actually operate totally independent. You literally don't use this mixer and that output virtual cable, and it all can be managed from here per source. I realized that this is a plugin that's worth its weight in gold. So I assume that in future they probably would integrate this into OBS, because it just makes sense. You can take every piece of media and route it to a different, either virtual cable, or if you have a sound card with multiple outputs, you could actually route it wherever you want to. Very, very powerful. So hopefully that helps you folk, and yeah, have a blessed day and shalom.